are holy. I really love you. In the Spirit, I love to worship you. Out of all things I am, everything I hope to be, if you look into my heart, there's a worshiper in me. Out of all the things I am, everything I hope to be, if you look into my heart, there's a worshiper in me. Worshiper in me. You are holy. Yes, you are God.
I really love you.
From the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul, in the Spirit, love to worship you,
love to worship you,
oh Lord, oh, you are. Don't you know we serve a holy God? I really love you. My God, oh, oh,
oh,
oh, I love to worship.
I love to worship you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, 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 oh,
out of all the things I am,
everything I hold, you look into my heart, there's a worshiper in me.
Out of all the things I am,
everything I hope to be, if you look into my heart, there's a worshiper in me. Worshiper in me. I love this. Listen. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and the worshiper is in me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and the worshiper is in me.
Spirit of the Lord is upon me,
and the worshiper,
and the worshiper is in me.
The Spirit of the Lord is.
Christ is risen. Come on, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Come on. Come on, saints of God. Come on, faith-based community. You didn't just join in just to hear me worship our King of Kings, our Lord of Lords. So you join me right now. Lift up holy hands. open up your mouth and give God some praise on this Monday morning, this Monday afternoon, this Monday evening, whenever you are watching this video. Just celebrate that He is risen indeed. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. The tomb is still empty. Our Lord still reigns. He sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Monday, November 15th, and I welcome you to our True Vision Church prayer call, where we get together at 12 o'clock noon on every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday simply to pray. Pastor Brown started this at the beginning of the pandemic almost 2 years ago now. And you know what? I'm mighty glad, because prayer still works. Prayer still changes things. I'm asking you to do me a favor. Not only join us every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday at 12 o'clock noon, but also like this video, share it with your family and friends. Join with us in prayer. You become an evangelist when you do that. And then comment during this prayer time. Set up your expression emojis. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, where this is happening even right now as well. How are you doing out there? What is your I am statement? We ask for that every single time, because it's our way of understanding and hearing how you're doing. I'm hungry. I'm hungry right now. Yes, I am. It's 12 o'clock noon. It's in the afternoon. And it's my lunchtime. But I feast off the word of God first before I go feast off man's food. So what is your I am statement today? Give it to us right now. Type it in to the chat. And then name one thing. Let's take a moment and boast on God. Name one thing that God did for you today. Not yesterday, not tomorrow. What He did for you today. But listen, again, we are here. Let me remind you, we're here to pray. So we're going to read scripture from our devotional book, our devotional guide that we've been using for 365 days. Get geared up. We're looking for the next one that we're going to use in the new year, where we read scripture. Today's title is Promises and Purposes. Promises and Purposes. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 20 is where Dr. Charles Stanley gets that idea from. Then we're going to pray for our sick and vulnerable. We're going to recite the Lord's Prayer before we do that, because our prayer topic today is sick and vulnerable. We'll do the Lord's Prayer, and then I'll come back. I'll lead us in prayer for our sick and vulnerable, and then we'll see you on tomorrow. Listen, let's go ahead and start by reading scripture today again. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 20. It says this: for all the promises of God in Him are yes, and in Him, amen, to the glory of God through us. Let me read that again. For all the promises of God in Him are yes, and in Him, amen, to the glory of God through us. Type amen for the reading of scripture on today. Amen. Let's recite our Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Heavenly Father, here we are again on this Monday, praying together, socially distanced, but Father, on one accord, because we're lifting up our sick and our vulnerable. The enemy would have us to think that the pandemic has ceased, but Father, the numbers still show that the pandemic exists. So we're still lifting coronavirus victims up to you. Those hospitalized, those whose body's been infected by it, those whose body's been affected by it. Father, we ask you to touch them and heal them, protect them. Now, Father, we also are lifting up those that are vulnerable. So those in the hospital rooms, those in sick beds, those in nursing homes, assisted living, those in hospice care, those that are elderly. Father, we lift them up to you. We ask you to continue to protect them and keep them and watch over them. God, let them know they're not alone, that you still have work for them to do, they still have purpose, that the promises are still to them and God is still on their side. Lord, let them know they're still loved, and put people around them that will care for them and nurture them, honor them. Only you can be everywhere at the same time, watching over all of our sick and vulnerable, Father. We thank you, God. It's in the mighty, the majestic name of Jesus Christ we do pray, our soon coming King. Hallelujah and amen. Listen, we thank you so much for hanging out with us, starting off your week, your work week in prayer. Join us tomorrow at 12 o'clock noon when we get together to pray again. Until then, God bless you. God keep you. It's our prayer for you. Peace.
Come on, everybody, put your hands together like this. That's it. We're going to have good old church. Can I hear the guitar? The guitar, please. Come on.